Moka.
No, it Moka.
Damn it.
Hey guys, it's the Hoyle Show.
In the next hour, we're going to delve in deep, and I hope revealing, detail into the sordid story of a hideous, mutated hunchback. Now, this repulsive and dangerous criminal goes by the name of... Oh, and please, ladies and gentlemen, get this name, and then maybe we should talk about immigration reform. Bob Maluga Luga Luga Luga.
Luga?
Who even now is stalking the streets of Los Angeles in search of his next victim, which could be you.
So don't you dare move.
I'm Stanley Horton.
Yeah! Here this afternoon, we've got them all for you. We've got the beauty that broke his heart, the opportunistic roommate,
the liberal college professor, the well-intentioned but naive instructor, the responsible judge. And of course, we're also very fortunate to have with us the astute psychiatrist who tried to warn them all, but audience, did they listen?
No!
Did they listen?
Let me ask you something. How'd you like to actually meet this Bob, the Boogie Woogie, whatever his name is, huh? We got him!
What?
Here he is!
Now, Dr. Fitz, let me ask you.
How does it make you feel to be the only person who pegged this dummy for what he really is?
But what's most important, though, is that this substantiates my original hypothesis, which is that social misfits should be separated from society. They should be isolated. I mean, they really should be...
locked up.
Yeah.
Locked up. I couldn't agree with you more. You know, as a matter of fact, I think the rest of these bleeding hearts are going to be held responsible for this maniac roaming the streets. Hey, folks, listen, let me tell you. I mean, I'm no lawyer, but from where I stand, these people are in big, big trouble.
Friends in big trouble. Where is this show?
KHB. It's a block left and about a mile down.
Right.
Hey! Hey, aren't you the...
No, I'm not! What time you got?
What? What time is it? 4:25!
4:25! Taxi! KHB Studios!
Right. You can close the door whenever you're ready.
Ready?
Go, go, go!
Stop leaking my neck!
Wasn't me, it was Dom!
That's right, they did not.
I'd like to say something. Can I say something?
What do you think? Can you say something?
Hey!
Give him a chance.
These dogs will cost you extra $2 a head.
How much for the rest of their bodies?
We originally agreed to appear here so Bob could show everybody all the things he's accomplished.
Oh, yeah? Is that why he knocked out two policemen?
How about that?
You talk funny.
You talk funny, too. Where are you from?
Transylvania.
That's where Pittsburgh is.
And what were you doing? You were running a daycare center for muggers? Probably. Maybe another human being from your point of view, pal, but certainly not from mine.
Excuse me, this is very unkind of you.
Unkind?
Yes, you have been extremely unkind.
Let me ask you something, okay? Would you marry it?
What time you got?
Quarter of five.
Quarter of five. Fakulaka! Go, go! I have signed the commitment papers, and I have them right here.
Well, I think that's very nice, Gramps, but as far as I'm concerned, you're a little slow off the mark. I think you should have thrown his big butt in jail to begin with.
Here is money. You keep dogs for Bob, okay?
Hey, sure. With a tip like this, I'll tip them till the cows come home.
From where? Oh, never mind.
Excuse me, do you have a pass?
No, thank you.
Guys, you got a problem.
Out of the way, Bruce!
Hold on there, Mr. Where are you?
Give me carrot!
Get for the oil show! Cut him off!
Can you believe it? Anyway, Darwin the great evolutionist once said that the only species that allows its misfits to reproduce is man. Now listen, it's our responsibility, it's our duty to keep these these monsters from poisoning the race. Am I right, folks? How about it? Gotcha!
Let me go! They're looking at my crest!
Why you lie to Bob?
Somebody get me down!
Get a camera and a mic over there. Let's let everyone hear what they're saying.
Why you tell Bob Kathy hurt?
We're gonna make a fool of me. We're gonna ruin my reputation.
Bob will tell everyone what you do.
Who do you think the world's gonna believe, you or me?
Wonderful.
Bob, I owe you
yeah.
an apology.
Well, where is it?
I apologize. Okay. Bob, you've been through so darn much lately. What do you think's going to happen to you now?
Don't know.
Well, I think with a little effort, we can get you a scholarship, Bob.
It would be a shame to waste such a wonderful tongue.
Mind.
What did I say? Oh, that would be so great. We could all be together again.
Yeah.
Bob, if you had to do it all over again, would you change anything? Would you do anything differently?
Do anything different? Yeah. This... Two speeds.
So in love, sad as could be, 'cause a pretty face got the best of me. Suddenly, you came into my life and gave it meaning and pure delight. Now good looks I've learned to do without, 'cause now I know it's love that really counts. Yeah, beauty's only skinny, yeah, yeah, yeah. Beauty's only skinny, oh yeah. Speak your words warm and sincere, and let me know that your love is here. A pretty face you may not possess, but what I like is your tenderness. A pretty face, maybe some guys taste, but I'll take love and